Hey, what do you say, everybody? Paul from Cleveland back with you. Let's keep going on Mike's cigar holder. It's supposed to get cold in the next few days, so I'd like to wrap up as much shop work as I can tonight while it's still reasonably warm. But there's really not a whole lot left to do on this project. Just some drum sanding and some final sanding, polishing, and so forth. But wanted to get done everything I need to get done out here tonight because it's supposed to get down in the 20s, at least for the foreseeable future. So, yeah, this is probably the last decent night that I'm going to have. So, you know what? Let's knock this thing out. I've got my smallest drum sander here chucked up in my drill press. My drill press is still on, still on medium setting. So, all I do is I just basically hold the material flat against the drum sander and just kind of just draw it back and just, you know, work it down. What I have to do is basically just kind of just eyeball it just as I'm pulling it and pulling it. And what I'm doing is I'm just working it down to get it as flat as possible and even with the slot that I cut earlier. So really, that's really all there is to it. It's pretty simple stuff. I just, you know, let me turn on the vacuum real quick. I don't want to breathe up acrylic dust. And I lose my vacuum hose, of course. Alright, I'm going to leave this like it is. You can see it's rough, but I would rather leave it rough and be able to go the rest of the way with files and X-Acto knife and so forth, because inevitably if you get too aggressive at this stage, all you'll do is just ruin it. So it's a whole lot easier to leave it rough and use the finer techniques to take it down from here. So yeah, that's all the drum work I'm going to do. The rest of it I'll do by hand. Alright, it looks like my disc is about to fill up. I'm going to take this thing to work along with my camera, and I'll pick it up there because the lighting is much better there, and I can explain a little bit more how I'm going to finish this thing the rest of the way. So, I'll see you tomorrow. Alright, let's see what we can get done with this thing. Obviously, I'm here in my office now. Back when I was making pipes, I used to bring them in here on my lunch hour, and I would do the finish work on them because obviously the lighting in here is much better than back in my garage. So that's why if you look in my drawer here, I've got, you know, saws, files, here's all my emery boards. You might have wondered, well, why, Paul, why would you take emery boards to work? It's because I would finish pipes here on my lunch hour. You know, I got pipe bowls, you know, I mean, pipe stems, you know, whole drawer full. So I'm going to turn the camera around. Let's take a look at this cigar holder. All right, let's take a better look at this thing. One of the things that you'll notice, I'll bring this other one in here. This is that one of mine. And I explained how I just did a little bit different geometry on this piece than I did with this one. And see how much bigger that looks just by, you know, going on the diagonal across that acrylic block, rather than just, you know, on the flat sides. And so I'm able to put a little bit of a, you know, a flare here. It just kind of, you know, dresses it up just a little bit. Now, granted, I'll take this down somewhat. This is just the starting size, but it's kind of funny just how much larger that thing looks, even though they're the exact same piece of acrylic, you know, exact same size acrylic on both pieces. Obviously, it's pretty rough from all the drum sanding work. First thing that I'll have to do is I have to remove the excess material from the corners and obviously take this side down just a little bit and, you know, get a uniform thickness all the way around. And that's a pretty simple job. It's just I'll wrap a piece of sandpaper around a block of wood and then just very slowly, you know, move up and down, up and down, up and down. And I use the block of wood. That just, you know, makes sure that I get a good straight finish in it. You know, it's not wavy or bowed in or out and so forth. So that'll be the first thing I do. And then the rest of it will be just, you know, sanding and shaping and so forth. Now, a technique that I use for acrylic is I try not to do too much sanding with acrylic because, quite frankly, I don't want to breathe acrylic dust. Now, this, you know, this work here, this will have to be done with sanding. And I'll just, you know, try not to be too aggressive and put a lot of acrylic dust in the air. But the rest of it, what I usually do, if I can find my X-Acto knife here, is I, instead of sanding, what I do is I scrape. And I just take an X-Acto knife and just, you know, just drag it. You know, and it removes a good bit of material. But instead of, you know, a lot of dust, I just get these, you know, stringies that generally static electricity will keep them from flying around. And so most of the shaping, the final shaping of this piece, I'll do just with, you know, scraping with an X-Acto knife. Now, one other thing I want to do with this is I want to put a little bit of a button on the end. Now, let me see if I can find a, pipe stem here and explain a little bit better what I'm talking about. You see how on this pipe stem there's this raised bead around the end of the stem? Well, that's called the button. And it's basically just, you know, a professional detail that most smoking pipes have. Matter of fact, practically all of them. I mean, I'm sure you could probably find a buttonless pipe stem if you really looked for it. But most of them have some sort of a, you know, raised area. And just, I guess, it just supposed to give you a little bit of extra grip when you bite down on the pipe stem. Well, I'll do the same thing with this. And how I'll do that is I'll take my little micro saw here, and I'll actually just, you know, saw an area on both sides, and then just remove the material down, you know, leave the material at the same height on the end, and remove a little bit of material down from the body here, and then I'll basically just raise this up a little bit. Then I'll do some shaping with the file and so forth. So, yeah, I'll show you that when I get a little bit closer to it. But right now, first thing I'm going to do is get these walls squared up and get everything the same thickness. All right, I got the wall thickness now where it needs to be. Probably a little bit more than a 1/16 of an inch, which is, you know, you don't need any more than that. That's plenty, you know, enough thickness, enough strength there to hold on to a cigar. I've also put a little bit of a bevel just on the inside so that the opening right here at the end is just a little bit bigger than the hole further down in. That'll just aid in, you know, fitting the cigar down in initially. So, yeah, the size there is where it needs to be. You can see it's getting closer in diameter to mine. Matter of fact, it's maybe just a hair larger. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to work on the tip back here. What I want to do is I want to work on that button. And so I scribed a line, and then where that line is, I'm just going to cut down a little bit, and that'll give me a slot there that I can then remove some material from this part of the holder and then leave this out here on the end and shape that later. Now, how I do that, how I score that line, real simple. I just lay my X-Acto sideways and then just do this number. Turn it around, do this number. And that way I can get an even line all the way across. It's kind of like a depth stop, just laying it against the desk like that. So the next thing I'll do is
I'll saw down a little bit. Now, I can't go too far, obviously, because if I do, I'll get into the slot. But you can see there, I could probably go down, oh, easily, you know, 32nd of an inch, maybe even a 16th of an inch. So, yeah, we want to get this thing thin, you know, so it's comfortable to use. You can see there's still a lot of material I can remove off of this tip. So, yeah, that's the next move. All right, the next thing I do is I just put a fresh blade in my X-Acto knife and I just start very slowly carving down and removing material. This is a particularly hard piece of acrylic. So, but yeah, it's just a matter of just carving it down. Oh, this is going to be fun. So this will take a few hours, so I'll pick it up when I get to the next step. All right, here you can see a little bit better that button taking shape. And I'm also getting the final width worked out. So this will be the shape of it. It'll flare out just a little bit and then taper back in. And then basically it's just taking the shape of a, you know, of a pipe stem. And so, you know, I'll clean up these edges. See how it's kind of bumpy along through here. That'll all be sanded smooth, and I'll probably reduce the width a little bit more. You can see this is a little bit closer to what the finished piece will look like, and here's what it was, you know, when I started with it rough and just had the slot for the button cut there. So yeah, another thing too you can see is some of this great marbling that's coming up. This has actually turned out to be a very nice piece of acrylic. Got a nice nice brown base with some grays and some reds and everything. This is really pretty. It's going to turn out to be a nice piece. So yeah, I'll keep working on it, start working on the other side, and there probably isn't going to be a whole lot left to show except for the final product, because from here on in it's just a matter of sanding. So yeah, I'll work a little bit more on it, maybe one more update when it's finished, and no, actually two more updates, because I've got to do something with that threading or the friction ridges down inside the body there. So I'll figure out something to do with that, and then do a final reveal when the piece is done. So yeah, not much longer now. All right, let's take a look at this thing. I've sanded it up through 400 grit. It's pretty much in the final shape that it's going to be in. You can see the button there. Not, you know, too pronounced, just enough there to make a little, you know, friction ridge, if you will. Just a little something to bite on. Color's looking nice. I really like that brown with the reddish, pinkish, I guess, maybe, accent. But how that red changes from like a red to a silver, depending on how you turn this. This is turning out really nice. Now, I will sand this all the way up through 2,000 grit. And then I will finish it off with polish pads. So there's still quite a bit of work to go on this thing. And of course, I still have to figure out those friction ridges on the inside. I'll figure something out for that. I'm thinking what I might do is I might take this thing over to Home Depot and see if I can find a bolt with a thread that's just a wee bit larger than this. And then just take, you know, a few minutes and just thread that in and thread it out, thread it in and thread it out. You know, and just, you know, put a thread down in there. I don't know. We'll see. Right now, I'm just going to continue working on the sanding and wrap that up. Then I'll worry about what to do inside of here later. But yeah, this is coming along nicely. A few more hours of sanding, and this thing is going to be wrapped up.
All right, let's wrap up this cigar holder project. Mike, everything is done. I'll do a close-up of this. There's one other thing I have to do. You had asked for threading down inside the chamber. And I mentioned in that first video that I didn't really have any tap and die tools. So I thought, well, maybe I could improvise something, you know, some kind of a, you know, soft material cutter of some sort, you know, and cut a thread down inside of here. Then I got to thinking about something. Threading this may not be a good idea, and here's why. If you cut a thread inside of this chamber, particularly if the thread is, you know, fairly deep, then what it is, it has the potential of creating a bypass airway. And what I mean is, it'll be a channel that when you draw on your cigar, instead of the air going through the cigar, it'll just go down through the thread. And so as you're trying to enjoy your cigar, what you're doing is you're basically just sucking a lot of air in, because the, you know, the path of least resistance would be for it to just follow that thread channel rather than go through the cigar. You know, a lot like the effect of trying to use a drinking straw with a hole in it. You know, you just keep drawing and drawing and drawing, but all you're getting is like air mixed with, you know, pop or whatever you're drinking. So I really thought, you know, threading might not be the right thing to do, even though I don't even have, you know, good thread tools to do it with properly. So what I'm going to do is instead I'm going to cut a few friction ridges inside of here, concentric rings, three of them, that'll just, you know, give a little bit of grip, a little bit of friction, but won't allow for any air to pass, because, you know, there won't be a continuous channel. There'll just be three concentric rings. And that way, when you put a cigar in here, it'll seal off, but then, you know, the ridges will give it, you know, just a little bit of grip. So what I've done is I've improvised a little tool where I've mounted three wire brads inside of a wood dowel. And I'll do a close-up of this, and I'm basically just going to put this down in here and rotate it around and then etch those grooves in with this little tool. So let me get things turned around and we'll see if we can get this done. All right, here is the here's the cigar holder. I've got all the finish work done on it. You can see it really took on a really nice luster. I'll do a final reveal of this after I've, you know, had a chance to give it a good clean up and everything. There's still a lot of sanding residue and things down in it. So, but yeah, it's really turned out to be a real nice, you know, dark collar with some little bit of accents. So anyway, let's do this these ridges. What I'm going to do is I'm basically just going to put the tool in, and it looks like, yeah, I had to, I just freehand made this tool, just kind of guesstimated the depth. Because if you remember, I cut a bevel in the very front of this, and that bevel goes down almost an eighth of an inch, you know, 3/32 anyway. So I didn't really want to try and cut any kind of a groove in that bevel. So I knew I had to be a little bit deeper than the bevel. And you know what? This is not looking too bad. Let me see if you can see that. Bring it up just a little bit. So you see, I'll just basically hold this against the side, you know, and rotate it around, and just use the teeth on these three wire brads that I've stuck in there to do the cutting. And I'm not going to cut real deep, because I've made these walls, you know, it's about a 16th of an inch. You wanted a thin wall, and so I've only got about a 16th of an inch to play with here, so I can't get real aggressive with, you know, getting in there and trying to cut a real deep slot or a real deep ring, because I'll just, you know, weaken the wall of the holder. So what if you remember, I had those two other pieces of scrap acrylic that I had drilled holes in. And what I found, so I, you know, tested this with one of those. And what I found is if I put the tool in and then take this little, you know, piece of emery that I've, you know, used for sanding, that just gives it a little bit of extra, you know, a little bit of extra width, just kind of stabilizes it a little bit. So I put it in. This is kind of hard to do on camera here. So I put it in like so. That holds it. And now all I'm going to do is I'm just going to rotate. See if I can angle this a little bit. You can see it better. I'm just going to rotate it like so. And you might hear those wire brads doing the cutting there. And I'm just going to rotate this, you know, until I get a sufficient channel cut. And again, I don't want to go too deep, because all I'll do is damage it. So
Now my suspicion was that when that channel finally, you know, got a good cut, that the cutting would get a little bit easier, which it's starting to do. Let me pull this out and take a look at it here. Yeah, you can see. The channels are, yeah. Looks like that's going to be okay. I've got to slow down. What I'm going to do is I'm going to do the rest of this off camera, because it's really hard to do this in front of the camera, because again, I'm having to hold it so far away from, you know, my eyesight, just so that I can have it in front of the camera. So I'm going to shut this down. I'm going to finish doing this, clean this thing up, and I'll do the final reveal on it. All right, this project is done. The lighting in here is not the best, but I'm going to, you know, turn this thing around and show the, you know, try to catch it in the best light as possible. One thing I do like about this acrylic is that the smoother the finish you get on it, the more translucent, the more iridescent it becomes. So this has got a real nice base of a nice dark brown with some, you know, lighter rose accents and some almost, you know, like pearlescent bits down through here. It's really nice. It turned out to be a fairly decent piece of acrylic altogether. I was real happy with it. Still need to do a little bit of cleanup. There's still a little bit of, you know, sanding debris down inside it. I'll work it out with a pipe cleaner and so forth. But this is the final thing, Mike. If you are still interested in this piece, I went ahead. One thing I also did is I blackened the interior, and that just kind of cut down on that that real loud pinkish hue that it had. It really softened that up a lot, you know, and turned that real pinkish color to this more kind of grayish pearl type consistency, which I really like how that turned out, because that pink, what was happening is light was coming through from the inside, and this area down here took on a completely different color than this part up through here. And so by just taking, you know, just blackening out the inside, that evened out the tone of the whole thing much, much better. So anyway, Mike, if you're still interested in this piece, drop me an email at pbandjohio@gmail.com. And we'll figure out how to get this to you. Thanks for watching, guys. It's been an interesting project. I might make another one of these for myself. I definitely like that fluted look, as opposed to the one of mine. I don't even know where mine went to, but yeah, much. I really, really like that. Let me see. Sorry, get my hand out of the way here. Here's mine. You can see just a much, much nicer, you know, classier appearance with that, you know, expanding line like that. I really like that. I'm gonna have to make one of these for myself. So anyway, Mike, here's my email. Drop me an email, and we'll work something out. So take care, guys.